The S-35 has successfully completed a critical testing phase in preparation for Flight 9. Despite some setbacks, it appears the countdown is finally on. Meanwhile, significant milestones have been reached across the board. OLM-2 has been fully assembled on Pad B, Booster 14 has reached the launch pad, and Test Tank 17 has made significant progress. Meanwhile, on the other side of the world, China is preparing to deliver its next module destined to upgrade the Tian Gong space station. Let's dive deeper in today's episode of NR Studio. Watching the S-35 as it makes its debut at the Massey test site after a major engine replacement. The first test attempt on May 11th faced an unexpected shutdown due to an unknown issue. Despite the setback, the SpaceX team quickly rallied and moved forward with unwavering determination. Just one day later, on the morning of May 12th, SpaceX conducted an additional static fire test involving the S-35. As per standard protocol, the vehicle underwent a complete fueling process. Emissions from the tank and vehicle indicated that the fueling process involved liquid oxygen and methane. Although the methane load was lower than that of liquid oxygen, it was much larger than that observed in previous tests. This suggested that a longer and more rigorous examination was in store, and that is exactly what happened. After a thorough check of all systems and ensuring their readiness, the engines fired to a loud roar. Thrust was routed through a fire trench system, which was specifically designed to protect the test bed and associated hardware from potential damage. Visuals showed a thick cloud of dust and intense flames from the engines, leading to estimates that all six engines successfully ignited, producing approximately 1,000 tons of thrust. The most notable aspect of the test was its length. According to observed footage and visual indicators, the engines appeared to burn for a full minute, marking it the longest static fire for a Starship upper stage recorded to date. In contrast, the previous record was held by S-3, which nearly reached the one-minute threshold. However, S-35 undoubtedly surpassed that milestone, setting a new standard for upper stage testing. During the test, observers observed that the engines appeared to cycle through thrust variations. This was likely intended to evaluate the adaptability and capabilities of the engine systems, bringing them closer to the conditions experienced during actual flight. As the test neared its conclusion, it appeared the vacuum engines were the first to be deactivated, potentially mimicking the anticipated shutdown sequence during the descent and landing phases of flight. After the engine was shut down, conventional tank ejection procedures began, and frost began to disappear from the surface of the vehicle. No public reports or indications of problems were observed, strongly suggesting that the test was a success. This incident further demonstrates SpaceX's remarkable ability to quickly identify and resolve technical challenges, even in high-pressure situations. After some initial uncertainty stemming from a previous challenge earlier this month, the successful long-duration burn of S-35 has reaffirmed that progress is on track. While it remains uncertain whether SpaceX will proceed with the next test using a single engine, it is clear that preparations are actively underway. Following the successful static fire test, a road closure was announced on May 13th with restrictions in place from 10 a.m. to 7 p.m. This closure will ease the route back from Massey to the factory. It is almost certain that S-35 is on its way back to Mega Bay 2. There, the vehicle will undergo a post-test evaluation, with particular attention being paid to the engine compartment. Given that the engine has had significant issues during its previous two flights, it is critical to ensure its integrity. In addition to performing engine inspections, SpaceX is expected to implement the flight termination system and integrate the payload into the vehicle. Once completed, the S-35 will be transported to the launch pad, where it will be integrated with the B-14. When discussing the B-14, it is important to note that the booster has already made significant progress. On the morning of May 12th, the carrier pad was successfully delivered to Mega Bay 1. That afternoon, B-14, adorned with its distinctive crown, left Mega Bay and headed for the launch pad. The launch was officially done and is now ready to be integrated. The synchronized actions of the S-35 and B-14 underscore the swift completion of the event. The next highly anticipated milestone, Flight 9, is fast approaching. The latest update from the FAA indicates that, contrary to previous estimates that had the launch scheduled for mid-May, the event is now expected to occur as early as May 21. While this indicates a small delay, It is clear that SpaceX is taking the extra time to ensure that all systems are thoroughly tested and fully prepared for the mission. Are you ready to experience Flight 9? If so, please write Go Flight 9 in the comments section below. Also, don't forget to like and subscribe to our channel to make sure you stay updated with every thrilling moment of SpaceX's incredible journey. In addition to the anticipation surrounding its imminent launch, SpaceX is making significant strides in developing its long-term infrastructure and improving its vehicle design. This progress is most evident with the progress on Pad B and the evolution of the next-gen Starship 5-3. On May 12th, the complete installation of the orbital launch cradle on Pad B took place, following an initial lift test conducted on May 11th. Using two large yellow cranes, SpaceX effectively lifted the OLM and placed it on the main structure of the launch pad. This achievement marks the successful completion of basic construction of Pad B, a process that has been unfolding over the past year. Basic construction of the tower marked the beginning of an extensive assembly process by SpaceX. The team meticulously assembled the various components of the tower while also developing the fire trench and flame deflector system. In parallel with these efforts, they erected the tank farm and eventually integrated the OLM into the overall structure of the launch pad. With these key elements in place, Pad B is now moving into the testing phase. A comprehensive system evaluation is anticipated in the near future, which is expected to include the integration of a Starship prototype. Test Tank 17 appears to be the front runner for this position, having played a key role in several recent key developments. Additionally, the launch pad can serve as a support platform for static firing tests of full-fledged super heavy thrusters, including the B-15, B-16, and B-17 models. Recent testing has validated the reliability of the new Pad B, which is now ready to begin supporting real-world missions. This could include significant milestones, such as the first attempt to capture a ship, potentially during Flight 10. Furthermore, it is anticipated that Pad B will be used for full-fledged launch operations, possibly beginning with Flight 11. The recent upgrades to Pad B, featuring the addition of a mobile OLM and a dedicated fire trench, mark significant advancements in Starship's launch infrastructure. These advancements are set to improve efficiency, safety, and reusability, playing a critical role in facilitating the rapid launch schedule that SpaceX is seeking to achieve. The Federal Aviation Administration, FAA, has approved as many as 25 launches annually from Starbase, setting an ambitious long-term goal of reaching a total of 400 launches in the next 4 years. Given this vision, it is not surprising that SpaceX is currently implementing comparable upgrades at its Florida launch facility. Following the dismantling of its previous OLM system, SpaceX appears to be moving toward adopting a similar mobile OLM and fire trench design. This strategic move is intended to establish a uniform and scalable infrastructure across its various launch sites. These extensive modifications go beyond simply upgrading the infrastructure. This modification paves the way for the next generation Starship vehicle, known as Version 3. Starship V3 is set to be the most powerful and advanced version to date. Development is currently underway, with Test Tank 17 serving as an early prototype for this version. The tank is currently located at the Massey test site, where it was recently raised into a compact structural cage positioned on a secondary mount. This unconventional arrangement has raised questions about its intended function, which remains ambiguous. This may be an important step in assessing the tank's mechanical characteristics, as well as its structural interfaces and thermal protection capabilities. As new information continues to emerge, it is clear that Test Tank 17 is only in the early stages of an extensive testing campaign. Further assessments are anticipated, including a potential integration test known as ADP-ADB. This test will play a critical role in verifying the design modifications implemented in the V3 series. This assessment will play a critical role in the progress of the first full V3 booster, designated B-18, which is expected to enter production in the near future. If the projected schedule is accurate, it is possible that B-18 will reach completion in the next few months and could even launch by the end of the year. Simultaneously, the first V-3 spacecraft, expected to be S-39, may begin its stacking process as soon as space becomes accessible at Mega Bay 2. This event is anticipated to occur after S-35 is transported to the launch site or after the stacking process for S-38 is complete. Stay tuned as we will witness the complete transformation of Starship in the coming months. China's aspirations in the space continue to grow, with the next significant advancement focused on the ongoing development of the Tian Gong space station. Since its construction began in 2021, the Tian Gong space station has rapidly evolved into a significant space platform, poised to become a long-term competitor to the aging International Space Station. The current structure features three major modules, Tianhou Core, and two laboratory modules named Wentian and Mingtian. However, these only serve as the foundation. From the beginning, China has had ambitious plans to transform Tian Gong into a comprehensive structure consisting of six modules. The proposed future design seeks to facilitate the inclusion of larger astronaut teams, expand the scope of scientific research efforts, and create new avenues for international cooperation. A significant indicator of the upcoming phase emerged on April 30th, when Wang Zhuai, a representative of the China Aerospace Science and Technology Corporation, CAASC, revealed during an interview with China's central television station, CCTV, that the upcoming launch of additional modules would be using China's most powerful rocket, the Long March 5B. The heavy-lift rocket has demonstrated its capabilities in the basic construction of Tian Gong and is now anticipated to play a key role in the deployment of new modules for the space station. While official dates for the upcoming habitable or science modules have not been disclosed, the important mission is already approaching. The Suntian Space Telescope, recognized as one of China's most advanced space science initiatives, is set to launch next year, with operations anticipated to begin in 2027. Often referred to as China's version of the Hubble Space Telescope, Suntian will be a powerful observatory located in low Earth orbit. The telescope has impressive dimensions, measuring 14 meters long and 4.5 meters in diameter, with an estimated weight of around 15.5 tons. It will feature a 2.5-meter primary telescope, in addition to a sophisticated camera with an impressive resolution of 2.5 gigapixels. Importantly, it will have a field of view that is 300 to 350 times larger than the Hubble Space Telescope, allowing for a wide, high-resolution survey of the universe. Suntian will share the same orbit as the Tian Gong space station, with plans to dock periodically for critical maintenance and refueling operations. Another illustration of China's strategic approach to long-term planning and a cohesive space agenda. In addition to its technological aspirations, China is positioning the Tian Gong space station as a hub for global collaboration. Earlier this year, it was revealed that Pakistan was preparing astronauts for training to begin a mission to the Tian Gong space station. This significant development would mark the first participation of non-Chinese astronauts on a Tian Gong mission. China's space authority has announced that it is currently in talks with several countries interested in sending their astronauts to the space station. China's focus on inclusion and collaboration has the potential to enhance its international partnerships and expand its influence in space diplomacy. By prioritizing these values, China can foster stronger alliances on the global stage. In line with its lofty ambitions, China is in the process of advancing a new generation of manned space vehicles. Currently, there are two versions under development, one of which is a partially reusable variant designed for low Earth orbit. This version has the capacity to carry between 6 and 7 astronauts or fewer crew members, along with the ability to carry up to 500 kilograms of cargo. Adaptability in crew and cargo operations is critical to the ongoing logistical needs of the station, especially as Tian Gong experiences increased activity and a growing population. China's methodical and strategic progress on the Tian Gong space station sends a clear message. This initiative is not only building a national laboratory in space, but also creating a vital hub for international cooperation and exploration in the space field. The pressing question now is how NASA and its collaborators will react. Will they accelerate progress toward a commercial alternative to the International Space Station, ISS, or will there be a stronger push for international collaboration and new investment in orbital infrastructure? Only time will tell. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one, and thank you for your support.